Sudden cardiac death. It happens just like lightning strike out of the blue and you're dead. Can't predict it. We've known that's not true for years. Go back to this Harvard Health newsletter from 2006. Here's their quote, not mine. Sudden death isn't always so sudden. The Hollywood picture is that it's like a bolt out of the blue. It's more like real lightning, preceded by clouds, wind, and rain. Think about it. Real lightning doesn't happen in clear blue sky. It happens in a storm. Here's the study that they were quoting. It was in circulation. It was from the University of Berlin back in 2006. Basically, here's what they did. They looked at 5,381 EMS missions. There were 406 cases of sudden cardiac death. Here's what they found. 2/3 of them had known cardiac disease. 72% happened at home. 2/3 of them, there was an eyewitness right there watching this happen. 80% had symptoms prior to arrest. 1/4 of them for over 2 hours had angina. 1/3 of them had angina for over an hour. Again, plenty of time to get this person into the hospital, to get them monitored, to get defibrillation ready, and to prevent that sudden cardiac death. If you've been watching this channel for a while, you know that we can actually prevent that death and predict it long before just an hour or two. We don't have to wait until this happens. Start looking at what's going on inside your body. You can prevent that heart attack and stroke. Others said you couldn't even predict. So this is a case, we've talked about it many times. You've heard about this case. Even if you don't recognize this slide, you'll remember the case. Washington, D.C., April 29th, back in 2008. Again, 2 years after this study showing that this is predictable. It's an EKG being done in the County District of Georgetown in D.C. Typical patient, 58-year-old, non-smoker, unremarkable family history. Cholesterol was unremarkable. Having some blood pressure problems, but controlled on medications. Was starting to have some issues in terms of the blood pressure and said, you know what, let's get a stress test and just make sure everything's okay. They adjusted the blood pressure medications and the patient returned to work. Until 6 weeks later, on Friday the 13th of June, he collapsed. CPR was done by coworkers. EMS was called. They, at 1:40, they arrived 4 minutes later. They did 3 defibrillations. They arrived a few minutes later at Sibley Memorial Hospital, where he was pronounced dead. He had a plaque in his left anterior descending artery. His doctor, Dr. Michael Newman, that did the stress test, appeared on Special Report with NBC to talk about what happened with Tim Russert and his sudden cardiac death. But you know what? Gosh, that was 2008. That was over a decade ago. We're much better now. We don't have that, right? That's not right. We still have people getting stress tests, having false negative stress tests, and having sudden cardiac death. If you've watched this channel, you know that you can actually start looking. First of all, you know that this is important. Heart attack is the number one cause of death in the US, and stroke is the leading cause of disability. And heart attack is the cause of sudden cardiac death. You can talk about fibrillation versus heart attack. Bottom line is, heart attack causes the fibrillation that causes sudden cardiac death. Bottom line is, predict a heart attack, you can prevent sudden cardiac death. Now, you also know, if you've been watching this for a while, that you have a huge possibility of getting a false negative, just like Tim Russert did. Get a stress test. Between 25 and over 30% of the negative stress tests are false negatives. So are you feeling lucky? Well then, don't get a stress test. We know how to work that up, and we'll talk about that in just a minute. Let's again mention the importance of heart attack and stroke. We've done a lot of things to manage heart attack and stroke risk. Blood pressure being one of the biggest ones, especially for stroke. LDL, maybe not so much the risk that we've continued to think in terms of your standard practitioner of medicine. In fact, over half of people, well, about half of people that have a heart attack have a normal LDL. So LDL is not as helpful as you might think. Meanwhile, heart attack death is making a major resurgence. We thought that it was going to come down to become not the number one cause anymore, but then that curve started changing again. And what are we doing about it? There's still over 8 million nuclear stress tests performed yearly in the United States. 1.5 million of those is predictably wrong. So, if you don't know some of the ways that we can predict a heart attack by getting appropriate testing, appropriate history, then give us a call. We can help you. Thank you very much for your interest. So I'd like to talk with you a minute about the webinar. People don't understand what the webinar is. It's actually a great way to get some access to healthcare that you're just not going to get any other way. You actually get the lab tests yourself at a local lab, a Quest lab near you, for the inflammation panel and the OGTT and the insulin survey. These are things, inflammation and prediabetes, that your doctor just does not know about. And here's the thing. Harvard Health and many others have said, look, sudden death is not always so sudden. The Hollywood picture that it's a bolt out of the blue is not realistic. It's more like real lightning, preceded by clouds, wind, and rain. Stop that metabolic storm before the lightning strikes. And here's where that metabolic storm comes from. It's inflammation, and it has to do usually with prediabetes. So again, we actually get labs, we go over them in the webinar, and then you can start finding out how you can prevent that heart attack others said that you couldn't even predict. We can show you how. Thanks.